These are 10 films that you should really avoid if you haven't watched any of them already. And in short, these are the 10 worst films of 2020 that I have seen. And I know there have been worse releases as coming from the response I've been getting from some of them, but these are only from the films that I have watched. So you're not going to be seeing Coolie Number One or Indugi Jawani, as most people have pointed out, as one of the worst. And these are only of the films that I've seen and reviewed. So if that's the reason why Coolie Number One and Indugi Jawani won't be in this movie at all. So just a heads. Normally, when I try to talk about a movie that's so bad that you should completely avoid, I do try to find some semblance of goodness in them. Like, there has to be something good in the movie that I can, say is like, okay, this aspect of the movie is good. Penguin has that. It's not something that you can, brag about. It's a movie in which the best character is a dog. A literal dog is the best character in the film. The only thing that keeps the movie going is Kirti Suresh's performance, and that's it. Everything else was so underwhelming, and I remember being bored for some of it. And aside from one creepy scene in the movie, there wasn't anything that salvageable from it. Then the more I try to think about the movie, the more logical problems that happens. I don't want to list all of them considering this is a list, so I say it's a movie that has a lot of logical flaws into the movie, and overall something you can really avoid because it's not that great a movie. It's available on Prime, but I say avoid it. The third installment in the ABCD franchise, and because ABCD was owned by Disney, they could not use that name, so they changed it to Street Dancer 3D. Yeah, I don't know why 3D was used for this film. The story is bad, and on top of that, they tried to cram so much into this movie that it ended up being a big mess. It was never organized in any way. The only good things that I actually were able to find in the film were Prabhudeva's dance. The choreography is really good. And while all the songs were remakes, I still liked Illegal Weapon and Mukabla and some parts of Dua Karo. And yeah. Aside from that, there wasn't anything that memorable in the movie as well. I don't remember anything in this film now that so much of time has passed. So that's a really bad thing. I can still remember so many things from the first ABCD and a little bit of things from the second ABCD. So I said this is a movie you can avoid. It's not gonna cost you much. Fatal Affair is a really underwhelming experience. It was really boring, to say the least. I didn't find any enjoyment in it, and there were some laughable moments, and not in a good way, considering it's like a crime thriller. And the concept has been done before. I've mentioned it in my review. This is the exact same concept as that of Hacked, the Vikram Bhatt movie starring Hina Khan. And despite that, I don't remember any of them. I'm trying to recollect from memory here, and the only thing I remember from it was that the killer has some teleportation abilities or some, like he gets into specific positions without making a single sound, even though he's wearing shoes and stuff. And certain things happen which are so cliched, and there are so many fake outs that, and the story has become so predictable. So I say all of this makes Fatal Affair a very, just shove it aside. It's on Netflix, but just avoid it. The remake of Mulan, and I mean the live action adaptation of it, is the next entry here because I found the movie to be very boring. It's a remake of the animated version of the same name. So I don't know how the animated version is. I still haven't watched it yet. I'm planning on doing that for another, you know, a review for some other day, because I'm trying to finish all my franchises. So anyways, the movie is very boring, and the two people that I expect a lot from was Donnie Yen and Jet Li, but even then, even they were so underwhelming in this film. There are certainly logical problems in this movie, which is very noticeable while you're watching it. And the main character was so wooden, like so stiff, you can barely get any emotion out of her. I have seen more emotion in some of the worst Bollywood films than in this, where she, even when she cries, it's like, and the scenes you're supposed to have a strong emotion for is not there. There are certain characters in the movie which their only job in it is to guide this main character to the next part of the story and nothing else, even though that certain character has the power to literally do anything she wants. But just avoid it unless you are planning on getting some boredom. But while there were some laughable moments in the previous ones, there wasn't, this one was just too boring. Speaking of bad remakes, Hindi decided Kanchana had to be remade into the Hindi version with Akshay Kumar. My friend also watched this movie. He hated the movie so much, and in my review I mentioned that there are some okay aspects in the film. I urge you to watch my review of it, but yeah, I can find some enjoyment in it if I'm channel surfing on a TV. It's one of those movies that, okay, I watched it, now I'm never gonna watch it again. It was mainly curiosity that made me want to watch this, because I was never that interested in a Kanchana. Aside from the second, you know, the actual Muni 2 Kanchana, I haven't seen any of the other, you know, Kanchanas in the Muni series. Even the latest one I have not seen. It was mainly the curiosity of the IMDb rating and people's reaction. Like, how bad could a Kanchana remake really be? There are so many logical aspects, logical flaws in the film, and most of them are very noticeable. There are certain things which makes you baffle, like, this is what is happening in a 2020 film. There are so many overacting scenes in the film, especially by the some of the supporting characters, even though I've seen them do well in other movies. I say avoid it. It's part of the Hotstar multiplex. This is one movie you can just throw it in the dustbin. My last movie review of 2020 was Kali Pili, and I just wanted to end my year with this because I didn't want to watch any other bad movies from 2020. So I decided this would be my last one, even though I think Kooli number one would have been a much worse experience. Kali Pili was nothing short of that, because experience wise there were certain creative transitional shots or certain creative shots in the film, especially, like, if you watched my review, there's a certain creative shot in which Ishan Khatri is talking to this dude, and it splits the two taxi cabs in such a way that it's like one taxi cab. Just watch my review of it, you'll understand. I didn't really care much for the songs, and again, it's a very forgetful movie. This is one of those few movies where even the female lead actually helps out the hero in a fight scene. It's Ananya Pandey, but still, I would rather have that than just have the female lead just stand there like a pillar, like it's in the fucking 90s or something. I mean, in a realistic sense, you would try to help out if you're in love with that person that much. So I'm kind of glad that the film actually went there, and I've only seen that in some few films, like in Baghi or something like that. Aside from that, it's a really forgetful movie, and I don't think you would even remember it after you watched it, to be honest. So just avoid it. I think it's on Z5. It's really bad. Fantasy Island is one of the, like, how would I say this? It's one of the worst films I've seen from Hollywood, I guess, because it's a complete fail as a horror. I think it's a remake or another adaptation of it, of an old Fantasy Island. But first of all, the casting was so wrong. Michael Pena is terribly miscast in the film. The concept was cool, though. I still stand by that. The concept was cool. It's a really cool concept, but what they did with it is like so bad. Even my parents, my grandmother who watched the movie with me, told me that this is really bad. Like, even she judged the performance as so bad. It's so boring at times as well too. So I said, just avoid it like anything, man. This movie is one of those movies that I regret watching. How can I don't really understand how someone can put a movie like this together. I hate this film. I legitimately hate these films. Like, the movies I'm going to say from here on is like the absolute worst. I cannot stress this enough how much I hate this. This is like one of the worst launching points for Amir Khan's niece, I think, Zion Marie or something like that. Like, I could not have picked a worse film for you to be launched in than Mrs. Serial Killer. And the movie had the balls to set up a part two. I don't care. I'm a completionist, so I might have to watch it, even if it comes out, but I don't want to watch it though. I hate it, but my mind is tuned in such a way that I want to watch it all the... no. It's... The performances are terrible. Manoj Bajpayee becomes a Joker in the end, and I'm talking about, you know, the DC character Joker. It's so bad. It's so predictable too, and in a crime movie, you don't really see the crime, you just see the end product. The way it's executed is also so bad. Just move on. Just avoid it if you haven't got the gist of it. This is still the worst Bollywood movie of 2020. Another movie was a bit more worse in experience wise, so that's why I'm putting Sadak 2 as in the number 2 spot. I hate this film. I don't like it. It's so forgetful. There are certain aspects in the film that I do not agree with. The dialogues and the delivery of dialogues is so bad. Aditya Roy Kapoor is a guy that's just there in the background just to react to things, and the backstory given to him is like nobody cares. Every single element in the movie is the exact same as the first Sadak, and I watched the first Sadak too. I have both movies in review form. You can check out my channel for it. I don't really understand the point of this movie, and it's a movie that didn't really need to exist. I understand business wise, like, it can be a good comeback, but everything in the movie is so weak that I don't know if anybody can even enjoy it. Right now, I want to, you know, show you some honorable mentions, or in this case, dishonorable mentions, because, you know, these are movies that are bad, but is like at least a one-time watch. Like, you can watch it once and then, you know, it's a good, okay watch for you. You're not gonna get any like bad experiences out of this. So I kind of feel like story wise it is bad, but it's like not the worst. These six movies, I feel like you can, you know, watch it once and forget about it. So let's start. Gunjan Saxena, The Cargill Girl is another Janhvi Kapoor movie where I gave it a 6, mostly because of Pankaj Tripathi, and he is the best thing in the movie. You can watch it just for him. And yeah, while I don't agree with the story as such, I made a review of it, you can watch. Pankaj Tripathi made the whole movie tolerable for me, so I gave it a 6. There were certain songs which were like okay, while some songs you could have just omitted completely. All in all, I can say you can watch it once. You're not going to get that bad, you know, thing out of it. I can see it inspiring a few, women, like it's a woman empowerment kind of a thing. It's just that the way it's done, I don't know if we can, you know, pull it off. Speaking of women empowerment, Miss India is a movie, Telugu film, which is dubbed in other languages. I wanted to watch this movie just for Kirti Suresh, because aside from Penguin, which is one of the worst, this movie was also bad, but it's also enjoyable in some ways. It's like Jagapati Babu and Kirti Suresh, the cat and mouse game that happens between them is like enjoyable at best. It's a really bad film because there are so many logical flaws in the movie, and I don't really see this as the big inspiration to women because there are so many filler that's in the movie. So I don't know, it's just enjoyable but in parts. So you can watch it once and be like okay about it. It's not gonna be like life changing for you, but it's like okay entertainment. V movie stars Nani and Sudhir Babu in the lead with Niveda Thomas, and I think this is our second Telugu film, or I think, but I don't know. It's very entertaining, but the story is like very weak. There's nothing much in the story, and it didn't match up to expectations. It's one of the things in the trailer, what Nani says, Mali expectation ki match avaledan anukodudu, but I have to say it didn't really match up to expectations. If you are going into this movie with zero expectations, then you'll be entertained by it, because don't expect anything from this. French Biryani is a movie that took me some time to watch. It really took me a lot of time because at first I didn't even know that it was released. Then on top of that, I didn't really have that much interest in it. Like, the name itself was like, okay, French Biryani. And after watching it, it's okay. It's, again, another film which is similar to Loot Case and Choked. It's entertaining in a few aspects. It's not, I can say, a very memorable film, because even I don't remember mostly anything from it. The TikTok star makes her debut in this film, and she's okay, but she has very few scenes. I can say the second half is what makes it a bit more enjoyable, because of a few parts were somewhat okay. For me, it's like a meh movie, and I can say, like, you can watch it once, you can watch it in a family time, but I can say it's meh. Sufiyum Sujathayum is a Malayalam film, but it's an okay drama if you're okay with the Islamic propaganda that is shown in the film. It's kind of like this forbidden love story kind of a thing with, and this is Aditi Rao's second Malayalam film after Pramani, I think. I don't know. Pramani or Prajapati, I don't know which one it is. But this is her second film, and I can say most of the time I was bored, but I can say there were actually okay things in the film. It's just that there's a lot of propaganda stuff that you had to push through, and the experience-wise, it wasn't all that. It was another kind of a film. Like, very average. Jayasurya is completely wasted in this role. He could have, like, Jayasurya is the only good thing in this film. Jayasurya and Aditi Rao, those two performances are like great. It's just that everything surrounding it is like okay, average kind of an experience. It's like an okay thing. And this movie is like one of the bad Vijay Devarakonda films. World Famous Lover is like an anthology film. Like, there are four kind of stories which are connected by this one story, and three of those stories I think are the writer's part. There are certain things. The worst part of this movie is that this one tries to copy Arjun Reddy. There's a few scenes in the film that it directly steals from Arjun Reddy itself, because, you know, he's Arjun Reddy made him a superstar, so why not copy from that thing? Even though I want to see him do something new with this newfound superstardom. So this one was kind of a big letdown, aside from performances and, yeah, especially from Rashi Khanna and Aishwarya Rajesh and Vijay Devarakonda. These three people, aside from these three, everything else was such a big letdown. The Arjun Reddy scenes, I did not want to see them again. And the storyline between Rashi Khanna and Vijay Devarakonda is so bad. It's like this guy keeps getting chances over chances over chances. I just didn't like it all that much. If I were going to watch it again, I would just watch the Aishwarya Rajesh storyline. That's like the only good thing for me. We're back to the worst film. The worst experience I had in 2020 was watching Virgin Bhanupriya. I despise this film. I do not want to watch it ever again. I don't even want to watch the trailer ever again. I don't want to even see the poster ever again. Rest of the films, even while boring, I never got angry at it. Mrs. Serial Killer and this movie are the only two films in 2020 that I legitimately got angry watching it. I was trying so hard while watching the film to contain my anger because I live in an apartment and I didn't want my parents to hear my anger. So I was trying so hard to contain it. Nothing in this movie works. Absolutely nothing. Urvashi tries in the movie. That's the only positive I can tell. Every single character is an idiot. I don't even know if they're from planet Earth. You have to, and the movie forces you to be in the mindset that a person like Urvashi cannot get laid. I cannot believe I had to keep uttering those words because that concept made of such thing was made. I found it absurd in Bang Bang. How would you think I would feel in this? Prior to watching this, I did not watch anything. Maybe a trailer or something, I don't know. Maybe I thought it was like a harmless kind of a thing, but no. And this movie has this opposite, this cliche where, since Urvashi's the kind of person that cannot get laid, cannot believe those words had to be had to come out of my mouth. She has a best friend who keeps getting laid all the time. So, you know, to get that contract, I would rather watch a Tom and Jerry cartoon than this. And the person she ends up with, I don't remember any songs. I remember the lyrics being fine, but I don't remember any of the songs now, so I guess that's a start. And I guess after this, I don't have to ever talk about it again. I made a whole review of it. You can just check that out. This is the worst film. This is the worst experience I had in this year. If this movie never came about, I think Sadak 2 would have, you know, occupied this spot. But because this film exists and because I never want to see this film and it's like one of the worst experiences I had, I have to put this in the number one spot. If possible, avoid it like anything. It's on Z5. It's not even worth a torrent download. It's not even worth that much data, to be honest with you. So just avoid it like anything. And those were my 10 worst films of 2020. Do you agree with my list? Let me know in the comments below and let me know your thoughts on let me know your list of 2020 worst films. Let me know. And if you like this video, please hit that like button, share this video with your friends and hit that subscribe button and hit that bell icon too so that you'll be notified when my videos are out. I can finally go back to watching good movies now. I think I might start with either the Avengers or I have another movie planned, but I think I'm gonna finish phase one now. So I'll see you in the next video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I do appreciate it. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.
forget, but you're breaking down my walls.